back in 1942, Worth had a hand in a daring commando raid to capture a German radar, Operation Biting. Radar signals had been detected from Bruneval on the French coast, and then a brave photographic reconnaissance pilot managed to obtain several photographs of this, which showed a strange bullfire-like object in front of the house. We spotted that we could get small boats very close to the cliffs nearby, and the idea was put forward of a commando raid to steal as much of the equipment as possible and bring it back to the UK. The plan was for a parachute drop of commandos, one of their number being an RAF flight sergeant, Flight Sergeant Cox, a radar specialist who would identify the key parts of the equipment, sketch as much of it as possible, and dismantle it for the commandos to carry down a cliff path to fast motorboats which would be waiting at the bottom of the cliff. The raid went reasonably well, but the Germans, once they had recovered from their surprise, put up a stiff resistance, and Cox found himself doing rapid dismantling of a radar with bullets flying past his ears. The last parts proved difficult to dismantle, so two commandos put a large boot on either side of the equipment rack and literally tore the equipment out of its mountings, following which they staggered down the cliff with it. The Navy arrived just in time, and Cox and the commandos climbed aboard with their valuable haul. Cox reported at once to a scientist who had come with the boat, Don Priest, shown here with a bit of the aerial of the German radar called Wurzburg. His first request was that of any landsman embarked on a 40-knot motorboat speeding over a choppy sea. "Permission to be sick, sir." Priest, not knowing if they'd get back, refused permission until a rapid description of the radar was gained. After which, Cox went back on deck, and we can draw a veil over the proceedings. Safely home, the Wurzburg yielded its secrets to the Worth scientists, not least of those secrets being the construction of the German sets was far in advance of our own in its detail and its precision. What the Germans had not done, but the British had, was to weld together all the parts of their air defense system into a single whole. It was, amazingly, in organization rather than in raw technology that the British had triumphed in the Battle of Britain. As Churchill said, they had developed a technically efficient system in some respects ahead of our own, but we had woven all into our defense system, and in this we led the world. Or, as the German fighter General Gannon said, the British had from the first an extraordinary advantage, never to be balanced out at any time in the whole war. Their radar and fighter control network. It was for us a very bitter surprise that Britain had a close-meshed radar system to the highest level of technique. We had nothing like it. But enough of self-congratulation. Back in 1942, it was not too long before someone high up thought we landed a raiding party near a radar station close to the channel, but our main radar research is at Worth. It is also on the shore of the channel and an easy route to the sea. Get them out of there! A place as far from the sea as possible, Malvern College in Worcestershire, was found, and all 2,000 researchers, equipment and all, were ordered to move there by Churchill before the next full moon.